Trinity.
All right. You are involved in the Trinity International Hip-Hop Festival. We've had some influential names in years past, and what are we to expect this year?
This year is going to be, it's going to be big, I think, for a number of reasons, but headlining is Rakim Allah, and for those that don't know, Rakim is probably the most gifted lyricist of all time.
That's some high praise.
It's pretty big, right?
Okay.
It's pretty,
yeah.
That's high praise. Live, so I walk up the street. Whistling this, feeling out of place, cause man, do I miss a pen and a paper, a stereo, a tape for me and Eric being a nice big plate of this, which is my favorite dish. So we have Rakim coming to headline, which is fantastic. And so this is essentially 3 to 4 days of workshops, film screenings. We have a Youth for Change conference on Saturday where we bring youth from Hartford to, on campus. We have performances, of course. So it's 4 days of just hip-hop cultural celebration. Yeah, so I fully expect Trinity to be the place to be April 7th
yeah.
through 10th.
Can we have a freestyle? Do you have any freestyle? Do you have any freestyle in you right now? No, no freestyle.
It's not happening. However, right, I haven't freestyled for 15 years.
Okay.
Since college.
Okay.
I was what you would call a college MC. And a college MC is basically someone who had all my friends who were college students. We would hang out, play video games. Somebody in the crew was a DJ.
Okay.
Who had instrumentals. And, you know, while we're playing video games, he's putting on beats, and people just were freestyling, and we're having fun. I haven't done that since.
Okay.
I'm not going to start now in the Smith House at Trinity College.
All right.
Freestyle. However, though, I will tell you that, you know, hip-hop is big. Hip-hop is something that really shaped my consciousness. In a lot of ways, it shaped my historical perspective. It got me interested in history. You know, I can tell you, I can do my first ever rhyme.
Okay.
I can do that for you.
I'm ready.
Ready? Are you going to do a beat? No, I'm just kidding.
Okay, no, I was about to say.
But very simple. So my name is, you know, my name's Seth. So I picked my MC name at that time. It was Mr. Fresh.
Mr. Fresh. There we go.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, that's good.
So it goes, you know, my name is Mr. Fresh. I am the best in the East and in the West, in the North and in the South. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Boom.
Hey. Mic drop.
That's a 7-year-old rhyme right there. My very first.
Hey, not bad for 7 years bad. Old. Not better bad. Than me at 20, yeah. You know? Yeah. I am wondering, I'm dying to know. This was actually a fan request.
Uh-huh.
They heard I was interviewing you, and they approached me, and they were like, you're interviewing Professor Markle? I was like, yes, I am. And they said, you have to ask him who his favorite hip-hop artists are today.
Yeah.
Like, either the big names,
sure.
The small names, maybe some big and some small.
Sure. U.S. artists, I am a big fan of Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah.
I am a big fan of Joey Badass out of Brooklyn. I lived in Brooklyn 10 years. I find that these two artists are very musically, you know, sound-wise, very good. And then they're gifted lyricists. And then they're also talk about something of substance.
Mm-hmm.
And then, let's see, I try to listen to J. Cole.
Mm-hmm.
Not really.
Can't
do it.
Okay.
You know my problem with today's hip-hop, and students in my global hip-hop cultures will know, because I'm always complaining about it. Yeah, I feel like it's gone lyrically or like content-wise. They're just very vulgar.
Yeah.
And I think it's maybe my ageism coming out, because hip-hop that I listened to back in the 90s, I think, was pretty vulgar.
Right.
But I thought it was cool.
Right.
As a 40-year-old, now I'm like, man, why did he have to say that? You didn't have to use it, you know. So, but a lot of it's really vulgar to me, and I just can't. Like, do you really have to use all of that? You know, particularly, I think we've reached the stage in the hip hop in the United States where there's this overuse of the word N word, and it bothers me.
Yeah,
it bothers me. It bothers me to go into a crowd and you'll see a majority non-black audience being like N word, N word, N word.
Yeah,
like,
I can see that.
Okay.